Head of UAMS warning of another possible surge in COVID cases and deaths in Arkansas. Even though our case numbers look low right now, Dr. Cam Patterson says that's not what we should be focusing on. Our newest KRK team member, Jessica Rank, joining us in studio to explain why. Welcome to the team, Jessica.
Thank you so much. Well, Dr. Patterson says we should instead be turning our eyes to the number of patients taking up ICU beds to really determine where we are in battling COVID-19. Over the last couple of months, they have doubled, and Dr. Patterson says the best way to stop another surge is to get vaccinated. At the beginning of the year, one by one, we saw people in Little Rock rolling up their sleeves, taking the first steps in the fight against COVID-19. But now the fire has turned into a slow burn. Arkansas reporting 40% of its people fully vaccinated.
And that's simply not a high enough percentage to have any meaningful impact.
Dr. Cam Patterson with UAMS says the numbers are a major concern when heading into the fall.
We know that there are more infectious and more potent variants that are now circulating.
One of those is the Delta variant. And Dr. Patterson says it's already affecting people in Arkansas.
Now we're seeing individuals who are childbearing age, who are sick enough not only to require treatment in an intensive care unit, but to be put on heart-lung bypass.
And according to the White House,
we have vaccinated in this country so many people who are 65 and older.
The young people are the ones who are skipping the shot.
If you're unvaccinated, irrespective of your age, irrespective of your medical conditions, you still can get the infection. And that means you still can get hospitalized, you still can end up in ICU.
Bashara Shukair says it comes down to questions people have concerning the vaccine.
Are the vaccines safe? Were they developed too fast? Those are legitimate questions, and we'd want to make sure that we're getting them the answers that they need.
Until then, Dr. Patterson says the state is, quote, at best smoldering, a long way away from the fire first lit at the beginning of the year. Yesterday, the state reported 75 COVID patients in the ICU, as compared to just a few months ago, where that number stood at 34 patients. Reporting in studio, I'm Jessica Rank. Back to you.